handshake. If this is a positive number, it will be a U shape, right? If it is a negative number, it will be a M shape, right? Okay, and for quadratic curve, there's something called the line of symmetry. And line of symmetry is always x equals to something, right? Because it's a vertical line. Okay, and also, line of symmetry will pass through the maximum or the minimum point. Okay, because it's symmetrical about that line. Symmetrical means that when I flow along the line, the two sides must coincide exactly. Clear? Okay. Now, then I ask you to draw two graphs, right? At home. One first, okay, one first. I'm going to revise through this first because after 1 week I'm worried that all of you have lost your memory. Okay? Somehow. Okay? Now let's all look at page 130. Okay, now this is the one that I have done the other time. Alright, now if you look at this particular curve, you have a U shape. This is the line of symmetry, this is the minimum point. Okay, now, like what I say, all listen up. The equation of the x-axis is y equals to 0, agree? Correct. The equation of the x-axis is y equals to 0. Now, what is the equation of the y-axis? X equals to 0. You must know that. Understand? If you do not know that later on, we cannot solve certain problems. Okay? Now, next thing. We went on to page 132. Look at this one, the last part. Okay. Now we have U and we have N. Okay. This is called the x-intercept. Now, what do you mean by x-intercept? Now, as the name suggests, y-intercept is the line, is the point whereby the curve cuts the y-axis, right? So x-intercept will be the point whereby the curve cuts the x-axis. Is that clear? Okay? When you have the line of symmetry, then they explain to you all the things that you can read through. This is what said on the board. Everybody okay? Alright? So, last term, I did page 129, 130, 131, and 132. Okay? And look at example 7 of this. On this particular page, 133. This one also, I have done it with the class. Okay, this example also, I have done it with the class. Is that clear to everyone? Yes or no? Yes, huh? Okay, this is where I have stopped. And I asked you to draw two graphs from here. Alright? Okay, well, don't worry, we'll carry on with that. Now, next, can we look at example 8 first? Don't look at the textbook, it's all in the textbook. I want you to know how to draw it. Because in upper secondary, right, this is only part of the question. And it's about 5 marks in here. Then I do this in the middle. Okay? Alright, let's go look at this question. The variables x and y are connected by the equations y equals to x squared plus 2x plus 2. Now thus, when you look at this particular equation, you already know that it's a U shape, right? Then why? Why is this a U shape?
Because the curve is U.
I know the curve is U, but from the equation you haven't drawn yet, how do you know it's a U shape? Because can you see that there's a positive one here? Now, then the question says it's always standard, all done. Calculate the value of P. I must calculate this right now. P, okay? So, I have the equation. Y equals to x squared plus 2x plus 2. I put in x equals to what? Negative 3, right? Is that right? Then you punch your calculator. 9 minus 6 plus 2. This will give you a 5. Now, it's not y equals to 5. What is it? Yes. P equals to 5. Can you see that they say calculate the value of P? You must say P equals to 5. Okay? The students will ask me, must we do all the working here? The answer is no. You just punch your calculator and give me the answer, can we? Understand what I'm talking about? Okay, now if I still have people talking to me, then I'll be very sad. It's a very easy thing to solve. The only thing that you have trouble is you cannot control the curve. Yes, I agree. Okay, now next. On a sheet of graph paper, using a scale of 2 cm represent 1 unit on the x-axis and 1 cm represent 2 units on the y-axis, draw the graph of this. Now, what is the meaning of this? That means x is from where? Negative 3 to 3. Okay? Then, use your graph in B to find, so on and so forth. Now, can I push this up and show you the graph? Then we are going to look at that. Okay? Alright, let's take a look at the graph. Now, the graph looks like that. Okay? Yeah. How are we going to read off? There are a lot of students who will read off the wrong thing. And you must read from the graph, not by calculation. Do you understand? Okay, now let's take a look at the question. See part 1. The value of y when x is 2.3. Or look at the board. I don't want people to look at the textbook. 2.3 means here, right? Alright, now you got to dot up, touch the curve, and then you read. What's the value? Look at your graph now on your textbook, please. Can you see it's 12? So y equals to 12. Okay? Now, can you look at part 2? The values of x when y is 3. Now, all look up here. Do you agree that when y is 3 is in the middle here? Yes or no? Now, you extend this way, it will hit the graph, right? Can you see that you extend this way, it will also hit the graph? There are two values. A lot of people will just hit one side and forget about the other side. Okay? But, plus, listen, if I say when y is 16, then it will only hit one part because this side we didn't extend. Do you understand? No? If you didn't extend, don't give me the value. Understand? Clear or don't clear? Okay, alright, so there are two values there, you just read it off. Everybody clear? Okay, next part. Part 3. The minimum value of y and the value of x at which it occurs. Okay, all look up now. Do you agree that this is the minimum value of y here? And it's at 1, right? I'm talking to you. Do you agree that this is 1? At which value of x did it occur? Negative 1. You understand? Okay, the minimum value of y is 1 and occurs at x equals to negative 1. This is how we answer the question. Everybody clear? Later we are going to answer it in our exercise. Clear? Okay? Alright, now, next. I need to revise the scale with you. Some people already forgot what is the scale. Oh, you look at the board? Do you agree that this is called 2 cm? Agree? This is 2 cm. Like that is what? 1 cm. 5 m² is 1 cm. Okay? Alright? So, always try and use the darker lines on your graph paper. Don't use the lighter one, then you're going to calculate after that. Clear? Okay. Now, next. Are you okay with example 8? Okay. Next, we go on to example 9. That is the next question. Okay, can we look at example 9? Page 135. Alright, page 135. Okay, I'm going to read the question up. Everybody must listen up. The variables x and y are connected by an equation, so on. Some values of x and the corresponding values of y are given in the table. Now, from this equation, can you tell me, is it a U or N?
U.
U or N?
N.
Why N? Because this is a negative 1, can you see? You must see the number in front of x squared. Not the first number that appears. Do you understand what I'm talking about here? If I do a rearrangement, you agree that I get this? If I do a rearrangement, do you agree I get this? So can you see this is a Alright, now, then next part. On the sheet of ground paper, use a skill given to draw this. Okay, let's look at the next part. They already draw it for you. Can you see that? Okay, no problem, they draw it for you. Now, let's look at the next question that they have given us. I want silence, and all of you look at the board and stop sleeping. Now, first question. Use your graph to find the value of x when y is what? Sorry, the value of y when x is negative 1.9. All of you look here. Negative 1.9 is here, right? You got to draw a dotted arrow down, touch the graph and pick right. Now, is there any use to draw a dotted arrow up or not? No use, you will never touch the curve, do you understand? You know what I'm saying? Because some people are like, so not correct any often. I don't know what you want, you must draw down, okay? Keep the curve. Okay, now, next, part two. The minimum value of y, sorry, the maximum value of y. Oh, look it up. Maximum value of y will be here, right? Can you see? What's the maximum value of y? 4. Are you very clear? 4. Okay. Next question. State the equation of the line of symmetry of the graph. Okay. Remember I told you the line of symmetry will pass through the maximum or the minimum point. Now, do you agree that the line of symmetry is this one? What is the equation of this? X equals to 1. X equals to 1, right? Now, don't say the equation is 1, it's wrong. The equation is X equals to 1. Everybody clear with what I'm saying? Can or cannot? Okay, good. Now, last example. This is a real-life context question. Okay? And nowadays, we like to set real-life context. After this, we can carry on with your grounding. Okay, no worries, I will guide you through. Alright, because this is important, set 3 you still need it. Alright, let's take a look. Bishop kicks a soccer ball vertically upwards. If you are interested in those, you can join them. Damon, you want to follow them? Oh, I look so happy when people are looking outside, but you're not happy when I'm talking about graphs. Can we join that? Because a lot of people walking outside. Some of people walking outside. A box of home. Want to do a dance? Up to you. Okay. Bishop kicks a soccer ball vertically upwards. The height pitch meters of the ball can be modeled by this. But if you look at this, can you see it's a negative 6 t squared? It must be an N shape. Can you see it? Okay. When t is the time in seconds after it leaves the graph. On a sheet of graph paper, using a scale of 2 cm represent 1 second on the t-axis and 1 cm represent 5 meters on the h-axis, draw the graph of this. Now, can you see that now the graph is no longer y and x, it's h and what? T. Alright, height against time. Alright? Height is in what here? What is the half of the time? Seconds, okay? Now, let me just warn you up. Time cannot have negative 1. You cannot say I have to draw from negative 1. No, okay? So it's from 0. You see they put all these on the side, right? Okay? Now, so they draw a graph like that. Okay?
No, it's not high, also cannot have negative
1. More first, I will tell you what happens. This is a real life context. Okay, now, can all of you look at the question of the textbook? Part B. Use your graph in A to find 1. The maximum height of the ball above the ground and the time at which this occurs. Now, all of you look here. Do you agree this is the maximum height? And what is it? What is it? Okay, it's ready. We need a clamp to clamp it. Okay, what is the height of here? Can you tell me?
Yeah.
The door outside is ready. What is it? again. Two five, right? I say you must read until half the smaller scale. Okay? 2.25 seconds. Everybody okay? Yes or no? Okay, it's the next part that's important. All of you look up. The time at which the ball will strike the ground again. Now, do you agree that when height is zero, it is at the ground? Then this person kick while for the right. It will hit the ground again here, right? What's the time? 4.5 seconds, right? Now, just now you have make up a good point here. They say height cannot be negative, right? Look at this one. This is already hitting the ground. What does it mean to go negative 15? Go to the ground. What do you mean? Dig the hole into the ground. Okay. It can also be the soccer field is near a river. A canal to our water. So whatever, okay? Hit the ground again, drop into the sea. That's why it's negative. This is the zero level. Correct? So, I did set a question like that in the exam. It was negative 2 cm because it's a marble. Marble cannot be negative 15 marble, so far away. Negative 2 cm. Then I ask, where do you think the ball is? Some people write very good. Some people say it's not possible. It's possible. Because there might be a hole down there, right? Then it went underground, correct? Or there might be a small lane, right? Small drain down there, right? Then it went underground. Clear? Understand what I'm saying? For example, I can also have this. This is the sea. Okay? The dolphin jump out of the hour. Can you see the dolphin stay here, right? Dolphin will go down, right? Alright, now this is the zero level. This will be the height that the dolphin jumps, right? This will be the height that's underground, right? So underground, under sea, not underground. Underground, the dolphin should be dying. Some will die. Okay? Do you understand? Alright, good. So, this is how it is done. Everybody okay so far? Yes. Okay, good. Take out the first round that you have done on your round paper. Question 4. I gave you 1 minute. Take out the round that you have done on question 4. All of it. Now. Now, number 4. The variables x and y are connected by the equation this. Some values of x and the corresponding values of y are given in the table. Now, we are very lucky this time. Can you see that the whole table is filled up? There's no unknowns, right? Okay, show me the graph. All of you write down the equation. Okay. Are we done? I say already, you must spot the curve. How many of you didn't spot the curve? You deserve to be thrown out of the class. everyone. Am I right? Stars. Can we look at me part one? I want everybody to stop. Use your graph in A to find the value of y when x is negative 1.5. Okay, all done. I don't want to draw. I say all look up. To draw, I throw away a graph paper, you draw again. Go and look for negative 1.5, right? It's over this side, right? Everybody okay?
Yes.
Then what do you do? Yes. You draw the dotted line up, read, and then you read, right? Alright? Can you do this for me? B, part 1. When x is negative 1.5, y is what? There's only one value. You must draw the dotted arrow. You cannot just use your eye. That's not working. Now, some people will ask me, where do I write the answer? You can either write the answer behind, if you don't want to clash. You can also write the answer in front, but it must be in pencil. Clear? Okay. So, all of you read from your own graph, because you'll give some allowance. What is your value of y? 9.1. How can you get 9 point something? Okay. Is it 9 point something? Okay. According to yours, don't have to worry about the rest. I will mark according to your graph. Get it? Okay? Next. Shh. Okay, next, part 2, the maximum value of y and the value of x at which this occurs. Okay, I want everyone to look at the bottom. I'll give you another 3 minutes. I'll look at the bottom. The maximum value will be the highest y, right? You just got to find this value. Understand? Then you knock down and find this value of x. Understand? You must want to find both. Part 2. Okay, okay. Maximum y is how much? When x is how much? This is how you present. Maximum y is how much? When x is how much? 3 minutes. Then you tell me the rough answer. Okay, now you look at part C. minus x minus x square equals 1.6 by 2. The B plus. Now, everybody hold up here. Shh, I'm going to explain this. This one means I must draw a line. Y equals to 10 minus x squared. Now, do you agree that this is already the curve? Correct. Then I must draw this one back. Y equals to what? 1.6, right? Do you agree? If I can get the intersection of these two, then I can get a solution. Am I right? Now, I repeat up. You must draw y equals to this and y equals to this. Correct. But I repeat. I repeat again. Because you're not listening, that's why you are. Look at me. I must draw this and I must draw this and they must be equal, right? Do you agree that this side is already the curve? So I must add this line, right? Y equals to negative 1.6. Sorry. Y equals to 1.6. Okay, now. What if they say to solve this equals to 4? What must I add?
Y equals to
4. Add y equals to 4. You understand now? But you must make sure this side is the curve. If not, cannot. Understand? Now what if I say I want to solve this? Then I add what? Y equals to 3. Do you follow what I'm saying? Okay, but you must make sure this side is the what? Is the curve. Understand now? Next year then we'll do what if it's not the curve, then how do we transform it to be the curve? Get it? Okay, so I want everybody to write it down. Part C. 10 minus x squared equals to 1.6. I want to say x y equals to 1.6. Write down this first. Y equals to 1.6. Now, can someone tell me y equals to something? Is it a horizontal or a vertical line? Horizontal. Now, you set up. You will draw a straight line, okay? At 1.6, so this is y equals to 1.6. Don't do yet. Look at the red line. Then you must read this one and read this one. Understand? You will get x equals to something or something. Clear? Okay, do it now. This must be a solid line. It's not reading off. It's an actual line that you add. Understand? When you read off, it's dotted. Draw y equals to 1.6. Okay, let's take a look at the question. The variables x and y are connected by the equation y equals to x squared minus 2x. Some values of x and y are given in the table. On a round paper, use the scale and draw. Okay, now, first of all, class, can you add in the equation? A lot of you will have forgotten the equation. Everybody okay so far? Okay. Next part. Use your graph in part A to find the values of x when y is 1. Now all of you look up here, please. Please look up here. When y is 1 is somewhere here, right? Okay, we are reading off. You got to go this way. And can you see it will also keep this way? So there are two values, okay? Yes or no? So B part 1. When y is 1, x equals to 2 values. Can you get this down? This is important.
Negative 2, 0, 2.
That's it. All hooked up. When x is negative 2, y is negative 2. Agree? When x is 0, what's y?
0.
Good. When x is 2, what's y?
2.
You draw the 3 points and you join it with a straight line. It should pass through the origin and it goes like that. Then you must label this y equals to x.
Complete that 2 and straight away, triple 5 is done.
Okay? Now, and I warn you, those people will never do anything during the holidays, right? When is my next lesson?
Tomorrow.
Is it tomorrow?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Are you very sure?
Yes.
Is tomorrow all these things must be done? Okay, nobody tell me I don't know, I don't know. Okay. Is it tomorrow or Wednesday? Paper. I said already, what? Every lesson must be fine, right? Let's look at number five. If a store prices each book at X dollar, 64 minus the any books will be sold. The total amount of money earned from the sale of the books is Y. Express Y in terms of X. Okay. I want everybody to turn to the back of the graph paper. I want to look at this question. All people in the car. One book costs how much? X, right? How many books are sold? 64 minus 8x, right? What is the amount of money collected? Y must be x times 64 minus 8x, right? Amira? Correct? Do you all agree? If you don't agree, tell me. Tell me you're wrong. Okay, I repeat. If a store prices each book at X dollar, this number of books will be sold. The total amount of money earned from the sale of the books is Y. Express Y in terms of X. I'll take number of books times the price of one book, right? Correct. This is Y in terms of X. And this Y is alone on the left side. Agree? Yes or no? So this is already part one. On the sheet of graph paper, using a scale of 2 cm represent $1 on the x-axis and 1 cm represent $10 on the y-axis, draw the graph of y for x between 0 and 8. That means part 2. You have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Yes? Can draw in front, but you don't clash with the graph. Okay? Then you use the equation and fill up the Y answer. Is that clear? Everybody okay? Okay, for example. Shh. I give you one example, lah. Go sleep. Hello, hello, look up. Shh. When X is 0, Y is 0, right? How about when x is 1? I'll have 1 times 61 minus 8 times 1, right? So it's 1 times 64 minus 8. 1 times 1. 51. 51. 56, right? 64 minus 8 is 56. So this will be 56, right? Everybody clear? Okay, alright, now, all of you look at the scale. Hello? I'm going to give my instructions now. I want to talk your problem. I will have 0 to 8 for the x-axis, right? And they say 2 cm, $1. How about y-axis? 1 cm, what? $10. Now, you must find out how much first. Understand? Then you will know the range. You cannot anyhow draw. Okay? Now, that means you must label it this way. Plus, you must put Y, this is the unit, right? In terms of dollar. This will be X, also in terms of dollar, right? So we'll have 0, 1, 2. Now, what did the Y-axis say? 1 cm to 1. $10. So it will be 10 20 all the way until you see which one. Understand now? Okay? Now, let me ask you a question. Can Y be negative?
No.
Y is the amount you earn. No matter what, you still earn, right? You cannot say, wow, I pay you back. Buy from me, I pay you back. Cannot be, all right? Huh? Chen, that's another problem. Okay? So, can you, your task for today, very easy. For those of you who didn't do the last two graphs, you must do it, I don't care. Right? For those of you who have done the last two graphs, very good, thank you very much. Okay? Can you complete this one and draw the graph for me? That's all. No need to answer. Everybody okay? Do you know what I'm talking about? Okay. We don't stop the video. Everybody start drawing now. Start drawing now. Calculate and start drawing.